Jay Williams, you watched that game last night, obviously. You said what you said about Luka Doncic. Let me ask you this question. What was your biggest takeaway from the game?
Just the way he manages the game, Stephen A. Like, in those moments, Chris Porzingis was incredible. You need him to continue to play that way. Mm-hmm. But it's the poise in which he sees the game. And the game is slowed down. He doesn't make the home run pass all the time. He gets you the base hit. Mm-hmm. He gets you on base. And if you watch where the ball is delivered at all times, it's delivered right in the pocket, ready for the opposing player to knock down the shot. He's just special.
We know he's special. We know he's special. How much do you believe in Porzingis? We all believe in Doncic. How much do you believe in Porzingis right now?
Long term or believe in him this year?
This year.
I believe in him. They're going to get out of the first. They're not going to get out of the first round.
Okay.
They're going to lose to the Clippers. Mm. But I still think Porzingis is a piece of the future. I think health is imperative for him. I mean, he's only played this amount of games he's been able to play. And him and Luka getting on the same page, that is the future for the Dallas Mavericks.
How do you feel about Doncic's going up against the Clippers? You've got Paul George, you've got Kawhi, you've got Patrick Beverley. We know how elite they can be defensively. They're a roller coaster, but we know how elite they can be defensively. If they were to meet the Dallas Mavericks, I'm talking about the Clippers, mm-hmm. in the postseason, talk to me about how you believe Luka Doncic would look against them.
I think he'll still look special. But I think the Clippers have so many bodies that they can throw at him. I think, look, Luka is very special, but him and LeBron are different, Stephen A. LeBron is a different type of level thought player and athlete. I think LeBron, with AD, can take the Lakers to a world championship. I do not think Luka, at this stage of his career, can elevate the Dallas Mavericks up to that point. But soon, it's coming. Mm. It's coming in due time.
Okay, let's transition, because we did bring up the Clippers. They got a game against the Houston Rockets tonight. We know how Russell Westbrook and James Harden have looked, albeit their last good game. They lost to the New York Knicks. We won't get into that right now. But when you think about the Rockets and what we've been saying about them, defensively, how much faith do you have in them?
Not against a Clipper team. I mean, they might win a regular season game at home, but in a seven-game series, I don't think I would see that long-term sustainable for them if this were to be the first matchup or the second matchup they meet in the Western Conference semifinals or the finals, depending upon where seeding is. I just think the Clippers have too much firepower to throw at Russ and James. Body after body after body. And if that's Kawhi, if that's PG, if that's Patrick Beverley, the names just Landry Shamet, the names go on and on and on. And that's going to be the issue for the Rockets.
Then why have we been raving about the Houston Rockets and their championship aspirations when everybody knows defense wins championships, but you can't find anybody that thinks too highly of them defensively?
Because if they get to the Western Conference Finals against the Clippers, that's a different type of game. If James Harden and Russell Westbrook get really, really hot, Stephen A., and they meet at that level, I think that's the only matchup nightmare for them. I think everybody else, they have an advantage against. And I'll say it. I think they have an advantage against the Lakers, because I don't think the Lakers can match up. I think they have an advantage against the Denver Nuggets. I think they have an advantage against Utah, all the other
Real quickly, so you're saying that the Houston Rockets will beat anybody else in the West outside of the Clippers?
I think they have a legitimate chance to. I really think they do. If James Harden and Russell Westbrook play at a high, high level, yes, they do.
Laura? Having a legitimate chance doesn't directly answer my question, but I will let Jay Williams off the hook for now. Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.